up? It's your girl More Dior, and I'm back with another video. So today's video is going to be about me coping with the death of my grandmother, and then not even that, I'm going to be explaining to you guys how I cope with it, how I've been, because a lot of people do DM me and ask me different stuff about it, and I never really talk about it because it's just like I don't like to sit there and, like, to this day I still don't believe that she died. You know how you lose somebody that's very, which I never lost somebody so close to me to the point where I'm still in disbelief that she died. So I want to actually help some people who's coping, who's depressed, who's like going through something that they don't have nobody to talk to about, or just like, you know, different stages of your life when you get to the depression mode. And I want to help you guys out with that. So please like, comment, and subscribe. Turn that bell on for more notifications. And we're trying to get to 100 subscribers, really 1K, because we trying to get this channel popping. So I've been talking about doing this video for like a month now. Seriously, I had spoke to my sister-in-law about it, and I was like, I need to do this video. I want to do this video to help people. I want to do this video to actually express my feelings. Like, because I'm a type of person, I express my feelings through text. And then not even that, I'm good at expressing my feelings by myself, or if I'm by myself, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I feel like I'll be good talking to you guys and actually, you know, doing this video to help people and just tell y'all how I overcame her death, or how I'm still coping with it. I haven't ever overcame it yet, we can say that. Okay, so boom, first I'm gonna show y'all her book. This is her booklet. My mom got this made. She got cremated, she didn't get buried. She wanted to get cremated. She been saying that since she was younger, like, you know, if she died, she want to get cremated. She was 76 years old. So her name was Helen White. She was 76 years old, and she died June 9th 2020. If you follow me on Instagram, then you've seen the post. She died at 3:20 a.m. so every time I see 3:20 p.m. my bad. So every time it's 3:20 a.m. 3:20 p.m. I just, you know, be like, dang, you know, and I just get in my feelings sometimes, but I'm gonna be good because I'm gonna make her proud. So little backstory on my grandmother. I want to read this, but I'm not going to read this because this is a lie, and I don't want to hold y'all. You get what I'm saying? So, my grandmother was from New Orleans, Louisiana. She had 5 kids. She loved to cook. She loved to bake. She loved crabbing. You know, all types of fun stuff. She was a very understanding person. I loved her. I would have never in my life, and still to this day, I cannot believe that she's gone. I swear, y'all. And I'm trying to be strong. I'm trying not to cry, seriously, because this is a hard video, and I knew this was going to be a hard video to make. So, me and my grandmother always, we was close, but I'm going to say, as I got older, she had got sick, like, to the point where one day she woke up and she couldn't move. So we were trying to figure out why she couldn't move, why we didn't know, and she didn't know. So she kept saying, something's wrong with me, but I don't know what's wrong with me, but I'm gonna be okay, I'm gonna be okay. So you know how black people is, let's be funny, y'all know we be like, oh, we gonna be good, like, we have a little cough, we gonna take some medicine, we gonna be good. So the next day she couldn't get up. So me, she had fibromyalgia. I have that too. So I know how I feel. Like, I swear it's like episodes. Like, you can be asleep and can't move at all. Seriously, like, you cannot move at all. You can't move. It hurts. It feels so weird. It feel like sleep, what's the word? Y'all know what I'm talking about. When you can't move in your sleep. So, basically, you know, she was like, she gonna be okay. She went to the doctor and they end up telling her that she had gout, something like that. And it was like fluid in her legs and all types of stuff. So it got to the point where she couldn't go to the restroom anymore. So she did have to wear diapers. My mom changed her and I also changed her. I used to help her a lot, like bathe and change her diapers. Like people, but this is what I tell people. Y'all, like most people see me, but they don't know what I like do or what I did. You know what I'm saying? Like they'll just sit and be like, oh, you know, I follow her on Instagram. Like if you don't know me for real, then you don't really know about this. You know what I'm saying? And some people that's close to me don't even know about it. But my grandmother tell everybody, like my granddaughter, she changed me. She did this, she did that, and I would have never in my life thought I'd do it. Seriously. And my grandma used to say that, so she was like, I would have never thought you would be the grandchild to do that. So I'm going to say around, as I got older, me and my grandma started to get close when she got sick, but I feel like her and my sister was always close because once my sister was born, I was close to my mom. For some reason, my sister was close to my grandma. But it's like around the time when my grandma was, you know, like she got older and I started to see it, me and my grandma got close. So I just feel like God do everything for a reason. So seriously, like I feel like our relationship was built off that. Like we had an even stronger bond as she got sick. So which me not even knowing she was gonna depart so early. So I feel like that's why I just thank God that I at least, you know, had the time to spend with her, because I was never knowing that she was about to go after she's sick, because she had got to the point where her kidneys got at 5% and they were saying she would have stayed in the house when one day she would have died. But it got to the point where she had to go to a nursing home because my mom couldn't take care of her no more, or me, like we couldn't do nothing else for her because, you know, she we just couldn't help her no more. Like she needed special care. And we tried almost everything to keep her here, which she didn't want to go to nursing home because she was used to being here. But she eventually got, you know, adapted to the nursing home. She liked it. So, I'ma say she started to get sick. And the first time I was changing her diapers, making sure she was good. So she had went to the hospital and I was crying because I thought she wasn't gonna come back home because, you know, the fact that she was sick and I was helping her. Hold up, y'all, I'm trying not to cry for real. So I was crying and my mom was like, everything gonna be okay because she's gonna come back home and all that. So I'm like, oh my god. So she ended up coming home that night and we had just moved in our new house, so I was happy. So then I'm gonna say around, y'all, I thought I wasn't gonna get emotional, but it's coming out, y'all, hold up. So I'm gonna say after that, I'm gonna say a year after that, she got a nursing home. She good. We used to go bring her food that she asked for, bring her snacks, you know, all types of stuff. So she was good. So I was in New Orleans. My birthday is March the 12th. She was in the nursing home like for almost going on three years, I think. I'm not sure, y'all. I really can't tell y'all how long she was in the nursing home, no, none of that, but I know she was in there for like 2 to 3 years, or I think that's the max. So I was in New Orleans around my birthday, so everybody know I got down there. My birthday was the 12th. We left at 13th and we were supposed to stay down there through the 15th. So I end up going to New Orleans, having fun, had my birthday party, you know, all that. So my dad was like, do you want to stay? Because that's when school had closed for my little sister. So I'm like, okay, cool, we might as well stay down here because we don't have nothing to do in Atlanta. So I'm like, okay, cool, we gonna stay. So we end up getting stuck out there because the coronavirus. So me and my grandma, we had like, we was real close, like I'm talking about real close. Like before she died, we was like close. I'm talking about we talk on the phone every day for hours. I'll post it on my Instagram. We'll be on the phone for like 30 minutes a day and stuff like that. They had bought her own phone, y'all. She didn't know how to stop calling. But now, I'm not gonna lie, I do miss her calling. But I never really miss none of her phone calls. I try not to, because, you know, she always used to tell me, like, you know, I'm sick, I'm not gonna live forever. So, you know, spend the time that you have with me. So, I'm gonna say, you know, we calling every day, we talking every day. So that's when coronavirus came out. So she had called me and she was like, me and my grandma was always we're spiritual connected. We always have been. Like, she used to read the Bible, we used to watch Bible stories. Like, she used to tell me about this or that. So anybody that, well, people don't know this about me, but I see things before they happen. So, and I also, no, okay, I'm gonna just leave it at that. I see things before it happens. So my grandma had called me. She was like, corona is bad, but they got this lady, she was a psychic, she predicted it. She had said how long it's gonna be here and all types of stuff. It's just crazy because the lady predicted it 10 years ago. I had looked the lady up because she had told me to, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna watch the video about her and all that. So she was good. I'm talking about, we was on the phone and everything, so we was good. So I'ma say a week after that, my mom had called me and she was like, you know, my mom, I don't know what happened. My mom is it? No. So I'ma say, oh no, my mom did call me. My mom was like, I thought I was gonna say the wrong thing. My mom called me, she was like, my mom getting sick. I don't know what's wrong with her. We call her my mom. I don't know what's wrong with her. Just check up on her, see, you know, like, just talk to her and when you can, because we don't know how this is gonna turn out, because it's really bad. So my mom didn't tell, okay, boom. So I called her the day she went in the hospital. So I was like, hello. She was like, she sounded so bad, not like herself. So I was like, hello, my mom. And she was like, hello. And I was like, she wasn't speaking how I'm speaking, but I'm telling y'all how the conversation went. She sounded real bad. And I was like, what's wrong? She was like, my heart beating so fast, they gave me some medicine because I had a cold. So I was like, you need to see what's wrong with you, because she was born with a enlarged heart. So that means her heart was bigger than what it's supposed to be. Not big, but it was bigger than what it's supposed to be. So I was like, you need to see what's wrong with you, because, you know, me thinking in my head, like, I don't want my grandma to have a heart attack and all this type of stuff. So she ended up telling the people. So she was like, I'm gonna call you right back, I love you. So I was like, I love you too. So then but that whole day, me and my cousin, we was going to a little like gathering at her cousin, at her friend house. And I kept saying, like, I swear, y'all, some kept telling me, call your grandma, because, like, I was like, we in the car. I was like, no, I'm gonna just call her later on tonight. Thank God I called her when I called her, because she had went to the hospital right after we got off the phone. Like, if I would have waited till later, I would have never have even talked to her before she left. So I kept saying, some kept saying, call your grandma. So if something keep telling me to do something, I do it. Seriously, I find it as a sign. So some kept telling me, call your grandma. So I ended up calling her, and I was like, you know, we had our conversation, so I hung up the phone. And then I'm going to say a week after that, my mom had called. She was like, it's looking bad for my mom. I just want y'all to be praying and be, like, pray and make sure y'all good and all this type of stuff. So the whole time, my grandma had caught the coronavirus from the nursing home. So my mom didn't want to tell us, because she said she didn't want us upset in New Orleans about it. But I had felt some type of way, because I was like, if something was to happen to her, I would have never knew what happened to her. So y'all, excuse me. So I was like, it gotta be deeper than what they saying, because if you saying she not probably gonna make it, then, you know, it's something serious. So I'ma say, you know, I'm just like, I just got to the point where I didn't believe she was gonna die, because I was like, if she came back at a 5% kidney, she's gonna do this. So, you know, me in my head, I'm thinking, my grandma's strong, she's a warrior, nothing is gonna happen to her. That's how I honestly felt, y'all, because if y'all see somebody come back at a 5% kidney, come on now, you gonna be like, okay, she gonna beat this. You get what I'm saying? So I was never thinking that it was gonna get to this point. So My mom, my dad was like, so do y'all want to leave today? Because if y'all grandma leave, like my mom, my dad and my grandma was really close too. Like she loved him like a son. So he was like, I want to see her before she leaves. So me in my head, I'm like, it's not, don't even say that because it's not going to be that. So it got to the point where my dad had called and he was like, my dad was like, do you need me to take them home? And my mom was like, no, don't take them home yet, because you know she didn't want us to come down there and be come down here and be stressing and stuff. So because she know how we was about her. So I'm gonna say we came back around the end of July, I'm gonna say, back to Atlanta. So we got home and my mom was like, it's really not looking good for mama, you know, the same stuff. So me, I'm just like, okay, she gonna pull through, I'm not worried. So my mom had shown me a picture of my grandmother, and when I saw the tools hooked up on her, I'm like, dang, it's real. Like, you know, and the people, like, she not responding, like we trying to do everything for her to get back, like to start back responding, she's not responding, none of that. So me, I'm like, oh my gosh, you know, that's all I'm thinking of. So June 9th, it got to the point where they like, you know, she only thing left for her to do is go to hospice. Y'all know what hospice is, I shouldn't have to tell y'all. Y'all probably should know what hospice is. Well, basically, if you don't know what it means, I'm just still want to explain it. It's like it's just like the point where they know you don't have left to live. Like, you know, you just stay there until you pass away. Like, they just prepare you to die. Like, you know, they clean your body, they make sure you good until you just pass away. So June 9th, what was I doing on June 9th? I don't remember exactly what I was doing, but I had went in the room and my mom was on the phone crying, my stepdad was rubbing her back, and my brother was just sitting on her bed like this. So I was in there and I heard them taking off the stuff off her and all that. So, you know, they take her off the machine and everything. So it's just like they preparing her to just take her own breaths, all that. Like, nothing is, no machines, no none of that. Like, you just gonna sit there and you gonna slowly pass away. So, I'm gonna say my mom was crying and all that, but I'm like, nothing is gonna happen to her. She gonna get off the machine and she's still gonna be breathing. So I'm gonna say like 3:12, and you know, they started to play her favorite gospel music and all that. So I'm just like, always being serious. So I just left out the room because I didn't want to hear all of that. So I came in my room. So my brother had came in my room and was like, T, that's what they called me, y'all. He was like, T, she gone. And I was like, what? And he was like, she gone. So y'all, I had went downstairs in my house, and I was just sitting on the sofa and was like, I just broke down crying because I was just like, how? Like, excuse me, y'all. I was just like, how? Like, why? Like, you know, me not even thinking that she really was gonna die. So my mom had came down there and my auntie Toy had walked through the door, and my mom was just holding me and I was just screaming, like crying, you know, all that, because I was real close to her. Like, it's just that really took effect on my life, like seriously. So I love y'all. So you know, so that happened. So I'm gonna insert clips of her funeral and, you know, all that stuff in the video so y'all can see exactly how the funeral went, what happened. We had a repast, a nice little repast, y'all. I'm trying so hard to hold everything in. So after that, you know, my mom had got a big picture printed of her. It's this one. So but this picture just looked like this because it's on here, but y'all had to see the picture. The picture is actually nice. She had printed a big picture of her and set it on the outside. So I bust out crying. I was like, can you please put the picture up? Like, I don't want to see that picture, because it was just still unbelievable that I seen her on the picture. So after that, it's just like I got, after that, we had her repast. We went shopping for her funeral. This is her obituary. My mom don't like the front picture, so please excuse it. That wasn't even supposed to be the picture, but this is how the obituary is. Hold on, I'm gonna finish the story for y'all. I just want to give y'all a little preview of the obituary, these pictures and stuff. And then here's the back. I actually spoke at my grandmother's funeral. I'll read it to y'all at the end. She had her repast and all that. But basically, let me read the poem that I said, and then I'm gonna tell y'all. So after that, I had said, if anything, I was gonna speak at her funeral because I know the type of connection we had, and I know what type of bond we had. So if anything that's left, I want to remember that I spoke at her funeral, and I want her to know I was strong, I did it, which I was crying when I said it, but I said I was gonna speak at it, and I meant it, and I did it. So what else? I spoke at the funeral. So here's what I wrote to her. It's right here. It say, "Dear Mama, my heart, my soul, my everything. I can't believe you left me. You were supposed to meet my kids. You were supposed to live to see me succeed with all my dreams and accomplish all my dreams that I wanted to accomplish. I know you're going to always be here with me mentally and spiritually because we had a very close bond with being spiritual. Even though it took for you to get sick for us to get real close, God knew what he was doing when we got close. When you first got sick, I remember you looked at me and I said, you said I would never have thought that you would be the grandchild to change and bathe me from a bed. And I looked at you and told you, I don't care what it takes, I'm gonna do it, and I'm not gonna complain. I'm always gonna be there, and I stood by your side every step of the way until you went into the nursing home. But to sum all this up, I love you so much. May your soul rest in peace, and please watch over me and protect me throughout everything, and help me get through every obstacle after this. I love you. Now for everybody, you can cry and close your mind, empty, and turn your back, or you can do what she wants. Smile, open your eyes, love, and go on. God saw you getting tired, and the cure was not to be. So he put his arms around you and whispered, come to me. With tearful eyes, we watched you and saw you pass away. Although we love you dearly, we could not make you stay. A golden heart has stopped beating. Working hands at rest. God broke our hearts to prove that he only take the best. So I did say that at her funeral. I'm gonna insert her balloon release and all that, but I feel like I didn't have to say that. Y'all obviously know we had a balloon release, but to sum all that up, I just want to tell y'all, I took my grief, I do get in my feelings with my grandmother. Oh y'all, let me show y'all. I had got a chain made, and my mom had got all this ashes with my grandma. All this chains with ashes on my grandma. I'll just insert a clip with that. I don't have to necessarily show y'all, but I might just get up and show y'all. I don't know, but I might still just put in a video. But to sum all that up, I just want y'all to let y'all know this. I took my grandma's death with, how I cope with it was like this. I don't really express myself as a person. I don't, unless I'm really hurt. So it's I only can really express myself through text or typing. So it's like I took her death and started my business, started my clothing boutique, started to the YouTube series. So it's like, I want y'all to know and understand that, someone close to you can die and you can be hurt, but you can also take that madness, that grief, to another level and help you succeed, actually. Like, you don't necessarily have to be sitting down, moping around, crying all the time, which I'm not telling you not to do that, because people grieve a different way. Like, I'm not going to say everybody can just get up and be like, oh, I'm going to have a good day, knowing they lost someone so close to them. But what I'm saying is, you can get up and cry, but also be like, oh, let me see how I can make a change in my life, or how I can succeed with something that I already planted in myself that I want to succeed, versus, like, you know, just sitting around crying and grieving because that person who died, I'm pretty sure they don't want you to just sit around and moping that they dying. Like I said, my grandma, I know for a fact my grandma was proud of me when she died, but I want her to be smiling. I want her to be more proud. I want her to be, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want her to just be clapping and hitting flips in heaven. You get what I'm saying? Period. So, I want it to be like, she know that I did it for her, and I also did it myself. I didn't mope around and cry like a normal, like, well, let me not say, let me, because I don't want y'all to think I'm saying it or make y'all feel some type of way when I say this, but I don't want y'all to just be sitting around and crying because you lost the loved one. Yeah, it's gonna hurt sometimes, but you have to take that grief into something so you can be successful. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want y'all to just be crying and moping around, because at the end of the day, your loved one wants you to be successful. Your loved one wants you to do something that you wasn't doing that's better when before they died. Like, so I took and started my clothing boutique. I took and started selling hair. I took and started my YouTube, like, taking YouTube serious. Like, knowing that I want to be somewhere in life where my grandma want me to be, or when she died I should have been, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, now I'm doing it for her. Anything that I didn't do while she wasn't here, I'm doing it now, so she can see, oh, like, my granddaughter really was serious about being this, or, you know, serious about understanding the concept of life and actually doing what you planted within yourself, and doing stuff that you actually wanted to do and not procrastinating. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it take time, but you have to turn a grief into success. Seriously, like, that's what I'm just doing this video to reach out to anybody. Like, if you're going through depression, if you're going through anything, you can text me, like, you can call me, you can, I'm talking about, I'll put my business number down just to help someone. Like, it's not all about being sad all the time. Sometimes you can turn that sadness, it's a happiness. Seriously, like, I just want everybody to be successful in life and not just moping around and, you know, sad because a family member died, when you can really make that family member proud by grieving. Like, I grieve every day. That's what people don't know. But I don't necessarily show it by crying. I show it by setting up this camera for YouTube. I set it up by setting up a little display to show my clothes. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like different ways to grieve. And I don't want y'all to grieve. Excuse me. I don't want y'all to grieve the wrong way and end up bad. Because some people could grieve themselves to death. Some people could grieve themselves into suicide. Some people could grieve themselves into depression and all types of stuff. And I don't want no one to do that. If anything, I want you to be successful with someone dying. Or I want you to be successful after someone dies, so they can see and they can look, you know, they could just sit back and be like, you know, they could be, because let me tell you, just because a person physically left does not mean their spirit is gone. So you can have a person that died and they spiritually still here with you, and they leading you on and they proud of you. So you should, like, you know, make them proud. Even though you can't see them physically, you should make their spirit proud. Like, I left, but this is what's going on earth, and they doing it. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I want. So it's like, I'm spiritually making my grandmother proud, and I know I'm going to do it, and I'm not going to stop doing it. But this for anybody who's grieving, who, and I'm just letting y'all know my situation, letting y'all know my story, because I'm not ashamed of it. It just was hard to do this video, and I knew it was going to be hard to do this video, but I want to help people. With anybody that's grieving real bad, I want you to turn that grieving bad into something good, like something good, even if it's selling lashes. I want you to see, you can turn that into something good. You don't necessarily have to mope around and cry. You can turn that mope around and cry into building a brand and excuse me, y'all, building a brand, promoting yourself, promoting, you know, just anything. Like, seriously, you can turn, basically what I'm like saying is you can turn grieving into something good. That's all I'm basically saying. But anybody that's going through something with someone dying or just depressed, period, because you can look at a person and not know what they're going through. And it's bad because some people just scared to open up to people because people don't actually understand them. So it's like if you grieving, if you depressed, if you just feel like you're not going to make it in life or you scared to just start something in life, just please DM me. Please text me. Like, just anything. Like, I'll drop my Instagram, which my Instagram is in the link down below, in the description down below. I just want to help people. Seriously, I want to help somebody become better than what they are from, and I want them to shake out of depression. I want them to shake out of grief and all that. But that's really the end of the story. I do want to tell y'all this, and I know some people are gonna look at this crazy, but my grandma did come visit me. I'm gonna say like after my mom's birthday, July 2nd, she came and visit me spiritually. I'm not going to tell y'all exactly what she said because, you know, but she did come see me. And the like I told y'all, last time I talked to her on the phone, she was like, I love you, I'm gonna call you back. She never called me back. I never got a chance to talk back to her, but she did call me back. And I asked her, was she okay? She was like, okay, I'm doing fine. It was scary, but it was true. It was her voice. And I swear to God, I still can't believe to this day that it was her voice on that phone. And I know my grandma is not living. And I'm not out of my mind. Don't think that something's wrong with me, because it's not. She had told me she loved me. She said she's doing fine. And I asked her, was that going to be my last time talking to her ever again? She just hung up the phone. So everybody who I told that was like, oh, she's going to call you back, or she's going to come, you know, visit you or whatever. But I'm not necessarily scared of it. I just was shocked because I didn't know she was going to come visit me that soon. Which, anybody that know, if you was spiritually connected with someone or just close to someone, when they die, they do come visit you, whether it's in your dream or just something like that. But I know I do want to help people, and I do want to help anybody that's going through depression, that's going through anything. Just please DM me and call me. I mean call me, anything. Like, seriously, you could ask for my number and just call my phone, and I'll make myself available for you just to help you. But yeah, that's my story. I just wanted to share with y'all because I know some people be scared to share their stories, and you know, I just want y'all to see the real me, like, not a more Dior on Instagram. I want y'all to see, like, I go through real stuff. I go through personal stuff. I go through hurt. I go through depression. I go through grief. It's normal. I'm a human being, and I want y'all to understand that. So all I have to say is just please like, comment, and subscribe. That's really what I wanted to tell y'all and let y'all see, like, you know, and let y'all understand I'm actually trying to help people. I'm actually trying to get a person to turn grief into success, seriously. But please like, comment, subscribe. My Instagram is in the description below. If you want to DM me or anything, call me, just text my DM and I'm going to reach out to you. And I'll give you my business phone number to call. We're on the way to 100 subscribers, period. Don't play with us. We is not one of them. But that's really it. I'm going to insert clips of my grandmother's funeral. The little thing my mom had got made for us. This video should be dropping tomorrow. I know y'all don't know what today is, so it's okay. We're going to drop the video anyway tomorrow. It is September 5th. So basically, I mean, I'm going to drop the video later on today. Let me see. I'm going to insert every clip, every picture, some funny stuff that happened at the repast, you know, anything. But that's really it. That's really it for the video. Excuse me. I just wanted y'all to see, once again, the real me. I want y'all to see that I want to help people turn grief into success. Seriously, that's what we have to do. Turn grief into success, because it's always a reward at the end. It's always a bright light at the end. I'm telling y'all, I promise you it is. But that's really it. Thank you for watching. Please share this video to people that you know that's like, seriously, y'all, please share this video to people that's depressed, people that's going through something, people that don't know how to deal with grief, just anything, seriously. But that's really it. So I'll see y'all when the next video drop. Period.
Chichi, go. Girl, I don't want that bird.